Hi, I'm Abhisheku Upadhyay, and today I'm going to present my project on bank loan case study. So this is our data set provided by Trainity. This having raw data. So this data have approximately 122 columns and 50,000 rows. So we have to first do standard EDA analysis. So this is a Trainity page. We can download dataset from here. As suggested by them, we have to first do identify the missing values and deal with the missing values. So before that, we have to do exploratory data analysis and to analyze the patterns of data. So let me show the Excel sheet. This is raw data downloaded by from Trainity portal, and here I do the EDA analysis. For EDA analysis, I simply first calculated the count blank function, use count blank function to find identify the number of blanks in a particular column. You can see, so this is the formula for count blank, that is equal to count blanks and then select the range. So after apply the formula on one cell, we have to simply select all cells, and then if we want to apply formula right to the all columns, then I have to simply select the columns and press Ctrl plus R, then the formula for apply for the same column. On the similar way, then we have to find out the percentage of blanks. In order to find out the percentage blank, we have to apply a formula like equal to then this cell upon, as I already told, this data set having 50,000 rows, in which first row is for column head. So we have to divide this value by 50,000 minus 1. So the value will come, and then you have to simply click on percentage sign, then the value will convert into percentage. So on the same way, I calculated the percentage of blanks for our columns. These are the columns. Then missing value analysis, we have to identify the proportion of missing value in each column. So for that, I simply I have to drop those column having percentage blanks value more than 35%. So these are the columns. These are the approx 49 columns having percentage blanks value more than 35%. So I have to drop these columns. Then some columns having blank percentage below 35%. So these are the columns which having blank values less than 35%. So these total 8 columns are there. We can apply or create a chart or bar chart to visualize the percentage of blank values. So these are the bar charts. Then in next missing proportion of next task handling missing values. So firstly, I removed all the columns which are having blank values more than 35%, and after that, for these blank cells, I followed these approach. I here mentioned the same. So the numeric columns missing value, I have to fill with their median. So for median, we have to simply use medial function in Excel. So numeric values column means column having values in numbers. So these are the number numeric columns. Numeric columns which having blank less than 35%. So these are the columns. I identify the median for these columns on the same way. So apply formula on for one column, then apply the same formula for other columns on which you want to analyze the median. On the other hand, I also inserted four additional columns because the value given in days. So I need to convert that. We can also use days, but year is much better than to analyze the data. So I converted these values into years, but days column having negative values also. In order to convert this into absolute value, we have to use absolute function in Excel. So this is the formula for absolute function. So simply I converted this into absolute and then year format. So that's why I added four more columns and then drop these columns having numbers in days. So this is my approach for handling missing values. One more thing, name type suit column having missing value, and I filled those values in by its mode. In order to identify the mode of this column means name type suit. So to identify the mode of this column name type suit. So in order to identify the mode of this column, we can use countif function or pivot table. This is our column name type suit. Firstly, we have to convert this column into table format. Then we can use pivot table. We can apply pivot table on this. Simply select this column, go to insert, then insert pivot table, and insert pivot table. Then it asks for the select range. Range is already selected this column. Then if we want to insert pivot table on new worksheet, then select new worksheet. Otherwise, if you want on existing worksheet, then you select existing and then click the place where we want to apply the pivot table. So I already applied, so no need to apply it again. So on the same way, I applied pivot table. Then the same function created a pivot table by using this column. And then we can see this column having 40,627 of unaccompanied value. So this is our mode. We can also use unique function to identify these values from particular column. So on this way I identify the mode and then fill the missing value of this column by its mode. On the same way, occupation type column missing value filled with unknown. In order to fill the details, we can use filter. Simply apply filter, then select blank, which column having, if any column having blank value, you have to simply select blank. Let me see. Actually, I already filled this column, so this column already don't have blanks. But if these are not filled with the missing values, then there will be a blank selection also there. So we have to simply select blank, then fill those blank cells as per this approach. So this is my approach to handling the missing value. I here also mentioned that we can also use Ctrl+H function to replace the missing value blank cells with particular value. Next we move to after filling all the blank values, then we have to becomes with complete data, but this the data also having outliers. So that is our task also, to identify the outliers. First task completed, that identify missing value and handle with them. Now the second task is identify outliers. So this complete data currently having outliers. In order to detect outliers, let me show you how I detected outliers. These are all data complete. I converted the data into table format. Then this is my process for detecting outliers. So for outlier detection, I utilize functions like quartile 1, quartile 3, then IQR, upper limit, lower limit. I also mentioned formula here, you can see. And for quartile 1, we have used accept function quartile.ext, then select the range and comma 1. For quartile 3, in the same way, select the range and comma 3. So I identify, I used this chart called box and whisker. Boss and Whisker chart to identify the and visualize the outliers for different columns. So this is our outliers. I can also show you my project report. These are the things which mentioning project description. When a customer applies for a loan, there are four possible outcomes. Whether loan approved, company has approved the loan application. Second is cancelled, the customer cancelled the application during the approval process. Refuse, company rejected the loan. Unused offer, the loan was approved but the customer did not use it. So my goal in this project it will do EDA to understand the customer attributes and loan attribute influence likelihood of the default. So this which I already explained. So I used Excel 2016, then PowerPoint presentation for making this report, and then Google Drive. As you know, we have to submit the project in the form of Google Drive shareable link. So I use this is my approach which I already explained. Data set having application data, previous application data and columns descriptions data. So most of the tasks apply on the applicable data. These are the data understanding slide in which the application data having total columns. I already told you the application data having 122 columns with 50,000 rows. Column is null value more than 35% was 49 columns, less than 35% was 8 columns. It means total that 57 columns having null values. The second file which is previous application data having 37 columns, 50,000 rows and null value is 15 columns. So these are the things which I had already explained. This is my approach. I also test snipped off that function. Yeah, so what I deduction, you already told I utilize the Excel function like quartile and IQR. So the next slide is outlier detection. So here I also mentioned that empty income total column having quartile, this which is extremely high salary. That is why we call this as a outlier. So in the same way, we can find this is high salary to n. In the same way, we can find outliers for each column. We can also insert this chart card box and whiskers graph. So again, go back to report. So these are the outliers detection process. If data is very high, my system is having some lags, it's hanging sometimes. So this is our outline detection process. Continue. Then the task C. Our two tasks completed. One is for missing value handling, then second is outlier detection. So after outline detection, B comes with final data. This final data, next task will be performed using this final data, other task. So now the next task is data imbalance analysis. We can see data is highly imbalanced. The significant majority of the instant belonging to class 0. Class 0 means non-defaulter. That is 91% data having 91% non-defaulter. Here I also use pivot table. I can see the pivot. So use the pivot table also. Yeah, this is pivot table data. So I use pivot table to count the data. Simply from the final data, I copied two columns. One is name contact type, second column is target. So I applied pivot table on target column, first on target column, then on the name contact type. So from this column, we can find how many loans having non-default, how many loans are in default status. The same way in this column, when I apply POIOT on this column, you can find the type of loans. So cash loans have been 36,892 numbers client. Revolving loan have been 4,177. Total 40,069 loans application. We can find max and min using max and min Excel function. We can calculate percentage of defaulter and non-defaulter. For calculating this, in order to identify the defaulter and non-defaulter, non-defaulter means the value which is zero. So percentage of non-defaulter means we have to divide this value by grand total, then convert the same into percentage. In the same way, for defaulter, we have to divide this value with total value and then convert the value into percentage. I here mentioned also, this means E3 upon E4. Non-defaulter means, percentage of non-defaulter means E2 upon E4. So on the same way, I identify number of cash loans and revolving loans. If we want to identify percentage of cash loans, percentage of revolving loans, simply divide H2 by H4 for revolving loan. We have to simply divide S3 by H4. we can create bar chart or 3D bar chart. Defaulted versus non-defaulted, we can create. So these are the pie charts. This is 3D pie chart. For defaulted and non-defaulted, we can create bar chart. So these are the values. In total application, 37,549 applications are non-defaulters, and 3,520 defaulters. So the next task is, this is imbalance data, imbalance task is completed. The next task is perform univariate segmented and bivariate analysis. So move to our next slide. Task D. It's hanging, actually it's having lots of data. Yeah, so task D is univariate segmented and bivariate analysis. So here I utilize various Excel functions like count, average, median, and other statistical functions for descriptive analysis. I utilize Excel features like filter, sorting, fiber table for this analysis. Let me show you how I prepared the data for this analysis. So first, we have to do segmented univariate analysis. So in segmented univariate analysis, we have to do the analysis for different columns. So first I analyze the column called AMT income total. So from final data, I copied the AMT income total, and with the same color, I also copy target column. So here I paste this. We have to apply this analysis on various columns. See, on the same way, the AMT credit column, then AMT NNT column, AMT good price column. Because it's segmented univariate analysis, so we have to apply univariate analysis on each segment. So these are the segment column. So in order to create income range from income total column, so I simply create first range, which is 0 to 50,000. And then if we want to create respective ranges, then I utilize the formula called concatenate. So for concatenate function, we have to simply click on equal to, then concatenate, then bracket open. Right means we have to select the range from this. Actually, first range is 0 to 50,000, then we want second range to be 50,000 plus. Started from 50,000 plus, and then end up with 1 lakh. So I use this function concatenate, then bracket open, right, then this column C2. You can see C2 column means this cell, comma 5 means here I mention right, then after C2 mention 5. It means that we have provided the range from 50,000 value, which is in the right of that C2 cell, which is 50,000. So concatenate function, then bracket open, right, comma 5. Then between first range and second range, we have to provide a dash or hyphen. So for providing hyphen, I mention this, then comma. Then we have to we have the maximum range for this cell is 1 lakh, which is 50,000 plus 50,000. So I mentioned here right, then cell number, which is C2, then call by loop, which is a 5 digit. The 50,000 having 5 digits. That's why here it's 5. If we want this left column, then we have to mention one C2 1. Here it's left, but we want range from the right. So from the right by loop. So here I mentioned C2 column comma 5 right. 5 means the number of digits in the right value of C2 cell. Same way, here I mentioned right, C2 comma 5 plus 50,000. So this is my range. Then again, on the same way, now here you can see column is C3, but value is 6 because 1 lakh have 6 digits. So C3 comma 6. On the same way, C3 comma 6 plus 50,000. So this ranges are extending 50,000 plus 50,000 from each other. So the second range, third range, fourth range, on the same way. Once we approach to this value, then I make last range edge greater than this value. So in order to identify number of applications between these ranges, so I use COUNTIFS function. COUNTIFS formula for COUNTIFS function is equal to COUNTIFS bracket open, then range. So we want create count these values for is between this range. We want count values from this column between these 0 to 50,000. So here I use COUNTIFS bracket open, the range of this column, comma, greater than or equal to, means value should be count those value which is greater than or equal to 0. Here I mentioned that left C2 1, it means then left C2 1 means C2 columns left value which is of first digit, 1 digit. 0 is have 1 digit. So greater than or equal to left C2 1. So it will count the value more than 0 or equal to 0. Then the next comma, the same way. Select range means this column, then comma less than right of C2, means we want value which are greater than 0 but less than 50,000, and from this column. So these are the value of 347. When I apply this formula, press enter, so it found 347. It means then there are 347 values in this column which having value 357, means we have 357 application from this column which have values between this range 0 to 50,000. On the same way, we can find values for these particular ranges. We can simply copy this formula from here. We can simply copy this formula from here. In this way, copy, press ESC, then go to this cell, put here, paste the value, and simply make some changes like here, the left column fill. Now we have identified range values between this range 50,000 to 1 lakh. So the left column value have been 5 digits, which is C3 comma 5. The right cell value having 6 digits, which is C3 C3 comma 6. So on the same way we can find the values. So these are the total application we have to identify. Then in between that application we have to identify the defaulter and non-defaulter. So in order to identify the non-defaulter, simply comma this formula in that cell, then comma, after this formula you can put comma, then select the range means this target value, because from the target column we can identify the non-defaulter and defaulter. So this target range means target column, comma, 0 means having non-defaulter, 0 means which are non-defaulters. So here comma 0, then put enter. On the same way, copy the formula from this cell into this cell, again put comma, then range which is target, comma 0. So in the same way we can find non-defaulter. In order to find defaulter, formula will be the same for this cell also, but instead of 0 we have to use 1, because 1 is the indicating that these are the defaulters. So on this way I calculated the non-defaulters and defaulters, and then created chart graphs, and on the same way I identified non-defaulters and defaulter for different segments. This is for empty credit, then empty, then amount, goods price. So these are the, so this is my approach for segmented univariate analysis. Now comes to the next point, which is univariate analysis. I can also show you the slide. Here I mentioned segmented univariate analysis. This is for our income range versus number of applicants. After calculating the values of non-defaulter defaulters, we can create charts. This is chart between income range and total application. This is chart between defaulter, non-defaulter and income range. And the same way for other segments also, I created tables and charts. So same mentioned in the slide. Different segments. Now univariate analysis. So univariate analysis can be done on various factors. One is demographic factor like gender, family status, age, number of family member, and number of children. These are the factors affecting in defaulting their own loan and not defaulting their own loan. So demographic factors means first we have to identify the gender factor on loan defaulting or not defaulting. So in univariate analysis, here from final data table I copied this column code gender and then target. On the same way, by applying pivot table, here I also mentioned the pivot table. This is our pivot table for education and occupation analysis. On the same way we can apply pivot table on this column and count how many males, how many females, and then use counting function. We can also use counting function to count number of males, number of females. But if we want non-defaulter, you can simply counting function formula, then male, then make this absolute and then put comma and then 0. So this is our non-defaulter. Count if, then select range means this column A, comma, we want to count m for male from this column. So in double inverted comma put m, then comma, and the target value means non-defaulter, target value 0 means non-defaulter. So comma, then I put this column, range of this column, then comma 0. On the same way for defaulter case, we have to put comma 1 instead of 0. For female, formula will be the same, but instead of M, we have to put F in females. So this is our formula. Here I mention F, but for female. Sorry, I mentioned M, but for female I simply change, replace M into F. The same way this also, for total we can add this E3, E4 column for total. Simply we have to find percentage defaulter, percentage not defaulter. For percentage defaulter, male, female. For male, do defaulter section, then put F3 upon F. Put this F3 upon total value. F3 upon total value means F5. For female, we have to put this F4 upon F5. F4 upon F5. Yeah. For non-defaulter percentage, so these are the non-defaulter, this is male, this is female column. So for percentage male, we have to put this upon this. For percentage female non-defaulter, we have to put this upon this. So I apply insert create table pie chart for both these analysis. This is our analysis based on gender, based on birth. I copied the column birth from this final data table. In the same way, we can identify the analysis based on birth age. So for age range, I created three ranges. One is between 20 to 40, which is a younger age. Then 41 to 60 means mid age. Then older means greater than 61. So we can use counting function on the same way. We use RDL. We can use counting function to count the ages between this range. These ranges. And then simply, the same way, apply this formula, then comma 1 for departure, and for non-departure, comma 0. For each range, we can find this departure and non-departure values. Then calculate percentage by applying formulas, percentage of age group, percentage of loan departure, then create table or chart or pie chart. So this is based on demographic analysis. Now comes to the family status. Family status means married, not married, single, civil marriage. These are the various status. We can use unique function to count the family status, or we can simply utilize pivot table. Here I can show. Yeah, this is our pivot table. I applied pivot table on this column, save these values, don't shift the type down, then click go to insert pivot table. On the same way, we can family status. We can also use countif function. Here I used countif function. Countif, then select the range means this column. Then this, so these are the total application, these are the defaulters, these are the non-defaulters. If we want to identify the percentage defaulter, we can divide this defaulter value by total application. So we can find the values for various family status and then insert a bar graph. Now next analysis is based on number of children, families having number of children, how many families have, how many children and percentage defaulter identify from them. So I created a range, 0 children, then 1 to 3 children, then 3 to 5 children, then greater than 5 children. Greater than 5 children means this is on the basis of age. In basis of family status, now basis of children, let me show you on the basis of children. Yeah, so greater than 5 means larger families. So here I identify the percentage defaulter and non-defaulter family status range and then insert the required graphs, required charts. In prepare report, I mentioned in report that family having greater than 5 children may exhibit a lower default risk. That is also showing in the graph. You can see that the family having children greater than 5 have approximately 0% default risk. Here I mentioned the same thing. Then the next point is family with 0 to 3 children are those with 3 to 5 children on the other hand, so slightly higher default rates. You can see I also copied the this analysis list from the Excel sheet on my report. So this and this is the same. So we can see the family having 0 to 3, 0 to 3, and 3 to 5. These are having defaulter value slightly increases. Now the next analysis based on family member. So I give this some range 1 to 4, then 4 to 6, and greater than 6. So after analyze the data, outcome is come on the basis of outcome. We can say families with 1 to 4 member and 4 to 6 member have similar default rates. We can also see from our analysis, but the families having more than 6 members having higher default rates, which is 14%. So it means that if the number of members increases in a family, then there is a high chance to loan to be default. So these are our analysis, univariate analysis. Now let us check the factor of education on loan defaulting and non-defaulting cases. So analysis based on education. So here one column in name of education, here employed, occupation, shakti. These are the columns indicating education occupation factor. So simply I first taken this column which having education type, applied pivot table on that column. So by applying private table, I found this list, education type. So 17 applications having academic degree. These are the applications having higher education. These are the applicants having incomplete higher. These are applicants having lower secondary education. These are applicants having C secondary or secondary education. So on the same way, for applying private table and occupation type column, we can see these number of these applicants are accounted. 739 applicants are cleaning staff, cooking, in the same way cooking staff and other staff we can find using pivot table. So I copied this data, this list from pivot table to here. So total, this is total application, this is their education type. Now in order to identify, we can also use country function. Earlier I used country function in that analysis, but we can use country function or pivot table. So I done two analysis based on using country function. Now I am going to show the analysis based on pivot table, using pivot table. You can use both counting function or pivot table. So this data counted from pivot table. Now for departure we have to use again counting function, counting, then the range means this is our range. Range means AQ 3 to AQ 4 to AQ 3 means this cell, from this cell to last cell, which is AQ 41,071. So I counted the applicant number of applicants having academic degree on this incumbent hire. Then for defaulter, use counting function, comma 1. For non-defaulter, use counting function, comma 0. Formula will be the same for this cell and this cell also, but difference is that for this cell, the comma 1 will replace by comma 0. We can calculate percentage. On the same way, we can find out this section. Then, after calculating all these things, I inserted bar chart. Yeah. Now the same way I created some range of year employed. 0 to 5, like 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 25. These are the year range, year applied range. Then I used counting function. Counting function now applied on this column, year applied between these range. So using counting function, I identify the number of applicant applied between these range. For defaulter, I use the same way, applied this formula, then comma, select the range means now the target range, and then comma. If it's for defaulter, then it's a comma 1, for non-defaulter, it's comma 0. So this is based on education and year employed. On the same way, we can find out, we can do the analysis based on occupation type. These are the occupations. So this is my univariate analysis. I use both the process like counting function and pivot table. Now comes to the next task, which is bivariate analysis. So I applied this analysis on empty income total, empty credit, and empty columns respectively. So again, I gave it some ranges, income range, in the similar way which I done earlier. Then for average, I applied average function to calculate the average credit between this range. In the same way, I calculated the average annuity on the basis of annuity between this range, income range, and then inserted a graph. So here comes our bivariate analysis. Now the next task is correlation of non-default. So this task be completed. Now next task is identify top correlation and different scenarios. So I did that in the same way. So top correlation, to identify the correlation, I created two work things. One is correlation for non-defaulter, then correlation for defaulters. So I taken up the data from final data table to identify the correlation. These are the column names. These are the column names on horizontal axis. These are the column names on vertical axis. We can also say these are the column. I use transport column, transform function to transport the columns into rows. Convert the column into rows. So if we want to identify the correlation between variable 1 and variable 2, this is our, these are the variable 1, these are the variable 2. So if we want to identify the correlation between this variable 1 and variable 2, so I simply use choral function. Choral, then b means this, b equal to choral, then the range is column number b, this column, then comma. Again, because we are identifying the correlation between empty income total and empty income total, so again the b column number B. So here it comes value of 1. Then choral column B, then column C. Means next we have to identify the correlation between this column. So choral comma this column range, then comma this column range. Yeah, so this is for choral between column B to column C. Then this is choral relation between column B and column D. On the same way, I identify the correlation values for each these columns respect to the these columns. For this, we have to apply choral, then select column which is in C. Yeah, this. So choral between column number C and column number B, then choral between column number C to D, choral between column number C to E, choral between column number C to F. On the same way, we have to identify choral between all these columns. Yeah. So these are the non-defaulter means I first, here I taken the columns which are having target value 0 only, means non-defaulter. Let me show you. Go to final data, then apply filter. For applying filter, we have to select shift, control shift plus L, or we can also use simply this sort and filter function. So here I, for non-defaulted, I selected only 0. So these are our columns, I think non-defaulted. So I pasted that into here. Yeah, the same way for defaulter, we have to select only 1. So then copy this data into oral for non, oral for defaulter, oral for defaulter 3. So after identify the correlation coefficient between all these factors, now we have to identify the top correlations. So these are the top correlation, top 5 correlation between non-defaulter. These are the top 5 correlation between defaulter, variable 1, variable 2. Means this, these rows represented variable 1 and these column represented variable 2. And the same way on this also. So top 5 correlation between non-defaulter, top 5 correlation between defaulter. So let me show you the report also. Yeah. The next file is previous application data. So on the same day, because video is becoming very lengthy, so on the same day, let me conclude this analysis. On the same day, we can analyze the data of previous application. So that's it. Thank you, everyone.